Our next contestant, empowering developers and security teams to use open source without drowning in security noise. Please welcome co-founder and CEO of Endor Labs, Varun Badhwar. Welcome.
Good to see you again.
Thanks for being here.
That's great.
There you go. I love the walk-in music, too.
I know. It's exciting.
Your time begins right now.
There's something common about every company presenting here and every other company on this planet. They all use more open source than they think they do. The root of this problem is at the heart of software engineering. Every time your developer's downloading one software package from the internet, it's bringing with it 77 other open source components. It's a bit like my family at home. My wife and I thought we were having a singleton baby, but we ended up with twins, except there's one big difference. The twins weren't conceived by complete strangers on the internet, but the open source code is. Now, the bigger problem at the root of this is that 95% of security issues end up in these dependencies that nobody's paying attention to deep within your open source dependency graph. Now, the US government now considers open source software a national security issue, which is obviously pretty evident by the efforts underway. But most importantly, my founder and I have previously created category-defining companies like CipherCloud, RedLock, Aporeto, and Prisma Cloud. And for us, we were fortunate to be on the leading end of this, thinking about this problem for 18 months ago when we founded Endor Labs. Now, you're wondering, how do we do this? We think in order to convincingly solve this problem, you have to intervene into the developer workflow and help them actually select more secure, more sustainable open source libraries. And once you do that, you can then arm the security teams with the mechanisms and the policies to actually focus on the security issues that actually cause a problem in your specific environment and get rid of all the compliance noise. And in addition to that, not every risk is a CVE. So open source has other issues, several other issues, outdated dependencies, unmaintained software, malware-ridden software. We help you facilitate all of that. And the outcome being, you can actually comply with SBOM initiatives and other emerging standards. The secret sauce behind all of this is a massive internet scale infrastructure we have built that's scanning 47 million open source packages and growing every day for their source code, their metadata around these projects, and essentially building a Carfax-like report for your open source software. Empowering that is AI technologies and advancements where we launched Droid GPT that allows developers to actually ask simple questions. What's the best LLM model open source package I can use that meets my enterprise requirements? Now, the biggest problem, though, let's be real, is developers being frustrated by all of that alert fatigue, which today's SCA tools deliver. And we head over heels solved that problem by changing how we scan the software and actually doing program analysis to find not just what open source you use, but down to the line of code, how you're using it, and basically providing evidence-based reachability and vulnerability prioritization. We have over 25 million in seed funding. We have 44 people in the company. We have over 40 CISOs who've personally invested in our adventure here. And most of all, we're proud that in the 18 months we're here, we have several large paying customers. Four of the top 10 banks in the country are in various stages of pilots with us. And ultimately, we're helping customers with massive alert fatigue reduction and building more resilient applications. There's a better way than SCA.